the last one. Would you mind to do my posture? And it's my 3 years old one, and it's called Shimmy Shimmy. So if you don't mind, do Shimmy Shimmy.
Shimmy 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 Shimmy.
Thank you. I don't have any gadgets or anything, but my passion, my love, and my mission in life is to create happy teens one at a time. And for the past 20 years, I've been working with teenagers in different kind of projects, in different kind of schools. And in between, I made 3 children. I'm going to talk about the firstborn one, who is 14. Story number one. So my husband and I decided that she's playing the Netflix, like she's watching Gossip Girls too much on Netflix. I'm talking 7 hours. And we decided to cancel Netflix, but we didn't tell her. So she comes back from school, and she goes to her room, and we're like downstairs, we're not saying a word. And then we hear the scream. No! The door is open. The door is always shut down or locked. She's coming down the stairs, and I will show you how. Quietly, she spread herself on the floor, and she makes a show that I was sure that she's possessed. I didn't know what was going on. Maybe my husband went out. So looking at my daughter, I'm thinking about positive psychology. I've been working with teenagers for so long. I said, okay, there's something that has to be there. And I've been working for, I'm teaching at a high school. So I came across this movie that's by Frontline. It's Inside the Teenager Brain. I said, okay, I'm going to crack this up. Apparently what's happening is that you know that there is like the jump of growth in the brain at the really young age, but apparently the same thing happens when they become teenagers. Now I have a quick question for you all. Who have teenager kids? Who was a teenager? Who is still a teenager? Men, only men, okay. That's later. Can you give me a few things that we know that happens to teenagers really quickly that you might remember or that you have the feeling about how it is to be a teen? Not everybody at once. Impulsive. What?
They forget everything.
Forget everything. They don't want to remember.
Insecurities.
What do you remember more? Emotions. So it's all drama and it's all like very bright with a lot of colors. And this movie showed me that everything happens apparently in the frontal cortex, right? Like over here, like in the front side of the brain. And basically this is what they are. And one of the things that the guy was talking about there in the movie is that if a teen is doing music or sports or academics, those are the cells and connections that will be hardwired. If they lie on the couch or playing video games or watching Gossip Girls, MTV, those are the cells and connections that are going to survive. I tell myself, okay, so I need to make something for my teenagers, my students, and for my daughter. But the things that were happening in the brain were not enough. And I went to something else which I learned about, which I really like, and it's called Identity Status by Marcia. We will play along here. Did everybody watch The Lion King?
Yeah.
Thank God. Okay. So, here we go, so it will go well. Who do we have?
Simba.
Simba. Simba, he's supposed to be the king. Why?
Son.
Because he was born into it and his father was into it. So to me, it's related for closure. What Marcia said, and don't get me into it, like if your grandfather was a lawyer and your dad is a lawyer, then you're going to be a lawyer because this is what we do in our family. So Simba is the king. He's supposed to be the king because he was born to that. Yeah, they had a scar down there, I love you, dad. Something happens. What happens to Simba?
He runs away.
He runs away. He runs away to who does he meet?
Nala.
No?
Pumbaa.
Timon and Pumbaa. I think Mega said about Hakuna Matata. Yeah. Perfect. So Simba is starting to live the life of Hakuna Matata. We're talking about a lion that was supposed to become the king and is eating worms and leaves for his life. And that related to me to identity diffusion, the Big Lebowski. The idea that I will just lay around and things will happen and I will be cool and I will be fine and I will relax and happy times because I'm cool and relaxed. So Steve has been living like that, he's growing up, remember the song he's doing with his head, da da da. Who comes?
Nala.
Nala comes. She's looking at him in very nice words. She's like, what are you, or what the F with you? Because I do have children. what is wrong with you? And he said, I don't know, I'm doing this, I'm not sure what I want to do. And that led it to me to the moratorium stage. Now, I don't know how you were as teenagers. I do remember purple hair. I do remember one day wearing this set of clothes and, you know, all grunge. The other day was wearing all black. I was going in between these two phases. And what he was talking about moratorium is the state that marks little bit commitment to an ideology or occupation, but it's also a state of experimentation. And this is something that happens to you as you're a teenager. Question? 5 minutes? Okay. Then. Oh, okay, that's okay. Then. So Simba is going, and now I started, what do you do? And he goes to the river. Now this is the part that I usually show at my workshop, workshops, because when he looks into the water, who does he see? The reflection of?
Mufasa.
Okay, and it's the monkey, so now everybody cries in that part. But Simba realizes what is his true destination, what he was ought to be, which is the king. And this stage is foreclosure. Simba is going to the whole circle, not because he was born to it, but because he decided that he wanted to be. This is the stage, or the state of clarity and development of one's identity. And I told myself, my daughter and my students are supposed to be this way because they need to go through those stages, which took me to the parents, or adults, or educators. So while I was doing this, I came across the book of Age of Opportunity, Lessons from New Science of Adolescence by Lawrence Steinberg, who is a child psychologist or child development researcher. And he's talking about self-regulation, what parents and for me, educators or adults can do. And he's talking about three things. And this is what I want to give you. Be warm, be firm, and be supportive. Be warm, you can't love your child too much. Be physically affectionate, try to understand and respond, provide a safe haven, and be involved in any child life. Be firm, make your expectations clear, be consistent, be fair, and avoid harsh punishment. And be supportive. Set your child to succeed, praise him to his accomplishment, but focus on the effort, not the outcome. Protect when you must, but permit when you can. Story number two, and this is what I needed this for. I'm taking a deep breath. Oh, we're towards the end. Oh man, okay.
Is black okay?
Yeah. Okay. So if you can see this, this is called positivity. Dot post. Remember my daughter? We left her lying on the floor screaming and kicking? Okay. That same daughter that doesn't want to hear what I have to say, that when I tell her, let's do some meditation together, she's like, yeah, not my thing. Quietly, with her friend, opened an Instagram account called positivity.post, where she posts only inspiring, wonderful things that inspire other kids. She has 400 followers, and if you want to follow,